Good morning, I am Devasena. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about time response analysis. In detail, we are going to discuss about that analysis of first order system. This topic is present in the subject, control systems. Response of a system. In electronic engineering and control theory, step response is the time behavior of the outputs of a general system when its inputs changes from 0 to 1 in a very short time. The concept can be extended to the abstract mathematical notation of a dynamical system using an evolution parameter. Time response analysis. In time response analysis, basically, system is tested in time instead of the frequency method. When a system is subjected to an input, its stability or response is named as transient response and steady state response. Time response representation is shown below. Here is a representation of a time response. A system is subjected to a input, standard input. Based on the input, we are obtaining the output. Immediately we are not obtaining the output. It takes some time to reach the steady state. Okay, the period before the system reaches the steady state is called as the transient state. The transient state as well as the steady state is represented in this diagram. Now we discuss about the transient response. One of the most important characteristics of the control systems is their transient response. The transient response is the response of a system as a function of time, because the purpose of control systems is to provide a desired response. The transient response of control systems often must be adjusted until it is satisfactory. Whenever there is an input change, the system cannot respond immediately. It requires some time. This time gap is referred as transient response. So, in transient response, the system is checked for its speed of response. Test signals. Four types of signals are encountered in practical system, which severely affects the time response analysis of a system. They are sudden change, shock, constant velocity, and constant acceleration. Types of test signals. Four types of standard test input signals are used. They are step input, impulse input, ramp input, and parabolic input. Step signal. The step signal imitate sudden change characteristic of the actual input signal. Here is the representation of a step signal. Mathematically, the step signal is represented as u of t is equal to a for the time duration greater than or equal to 0, and its value is equal to 0 for the time less than 0. If a is equal to 1, the step signal is called unit step signal. Taking Laplace transform of step signal is Laplace of u of t is equal to Laplace of a, that is equal to a by s. Impulse signal. The impulse signal imitate sudden shock characteristic of the actual input signal. Here is the representation of a impulse signal. Mathematically, the impulse signal is represented as delta of t is equal to a when t is equal to 0, and its value delta of t is equal to 0 for t is not equal to 0. If A unit impulse function is a signal having a large amplitude and exists for a short time.
Ramp signal. Ramp signal imitates the constant velocity characteristic of the actual input signal. There is a representation of a ramp signal. Mathematically, the ramp signal is represented as r of t is equal to at, where t is greater than or equal to 0. Its value is equal to 0 when t is less than 0. If a is equal to 1, the ramp signal is called unit ramp signal.
Parabolic signal. The parabolic signal imitates the constant acceleration characteristic of actual input signal. Here is a representation of a parabolic signal. Mathematically, the parabolic signal is represented as p of t is equal to at square by 2 for t is greater than or equal to 0, and its value is equal to 0 for t is less than 0. If a is equal to 1, the parabolic signal is called unit parabolic signal. Time response analysis of first order system. Consider a first order system shown in figure below. Here is a representation of a first order system. For this system, the value of the g of s is equal to 1 by ts, and a unity feedback is applied having a negative sign, and r of s is the input signal and c of s is your output signal. The closed loop transfer function is given by the ratio of the Laplace transform of the output signal to the Laplace transform of the input signal. That is, C of s by R of s is equal to G of s divided by 1 plus G of s H of s. Here, we have applied a negative feedback. That is why we have used this formula, G of s divided by 1 plus G of s H of s. And if you substitute the values of g of s in this equation, means we get 1 divided by ts divided by 1 plus 1 by ts into 1, because the value of the h of s is 1. If you simplify, means we get 1 divided by ts plus 1, where t is known as time constant of the system.
Time response analysis of first order system subjected to unit step input. The closed loop transfer function of the first order system is given by C of s by R of s is equal to 1 divided by Ts plus 1. That is, C of s is equal to R of s divided by Ts plus 1. For unit step input, the value of R of s is equal to 1 by s. Therefore, C of s is equal to 1 divided by s into 1 plus ts. Here we have substituted the value of R of s is equal to 1 by s. Therefore, we have to simplify this C of s with the help of this partial fraction. That is, C of s is equal to a divided by s plus b divided by s into 1 plus ts. By partial fraction technique, the value of a and b can be calculated. To find the value of a and b, we have 1 is equal to a into open bracket 1 plus ts close the bracket plus bs. That is, 1 is equal to a plus ats plus bs. That is equal to a plus s into open bracket at plus b close the bracket. Now, we have to calculate the values of A and B. For calculating the values of A and B, we have to equate the coefficients of constant term and S term. Now, equating the coefficients of constant term, we get A is equal to 1. Now, if we equate the S term, means we get AT plus B is equal to 0. We know the value of A is equal to 1. So just substitute the value of A is equal to 1 in the above equation. We get t plus b is equal to 0. That is, the value of b is equal to minus t. Therefore, substitute the values of a and b in C of s equation. We get C of s is equal to 1 by s plus minus t divided by s into 1 plus t s. That is equal to 1 divided by s minus t divided by s into 1 plus t s. That is C of s is equal to 1 divided by s minus, here we have taken t and that t term is cancelled in the numerator. So we get 1 divided by the denominator, we have s plus 1 divided by t. Taking inverse Laplace transform of C of s means we get Laplace inverse of C of s, that is equal to Laplace inverse of 1 by s minus 1 divided by s plus 1 by t. That is, Laplace inverse of C of s is C of t. C of t is equal to Laplace inverse of 1 by s is 1, and Laplace inverse of 1 divided by s plus 1 by t value is e power minus t divided by capital T. That is, C of t is equal to 1 minus e power minus t by capital T. The steady state error is given by e suffix ss is equal to limits t tends to infinity, open bracket, r of t minus c of t, close the bracket. We know the value of the r of t and we know the value of the c of t. So substitute the values of r of t and c of t in this equation. We get e suffix ss is equal to limit t tends to infinity. The value of r of t is 1, so 1 minus, and the value of c of t is 1 minus e power minus t by t. That is, limit t tends to infinity 1 minus, open bracket, 1 minus e power minus t by t, closer bracket. So after applying the limits t tends to infinity, we get e suffix ss is equal to 1 minus, open bracket, 1 minus e power minus infinity, closer bracket, and close the other bracket. So we get e suffix ss is equal to e power minus infinity and its value is equal to 0. Since e suffix ss is equal to 0, the first order system is capable of responding to a unit step without any steady state error. The speed of response depends to the time constant t. Smaller the time constant t, faster will be the speed of the response. Time response analysis of first order system subjected to unit ramp input. The closed loop transfer function of the first order system is given by C of s by R of s is equal to 1 divided by Ts plus 1. C of s is equal to R of s divided by Ts plus 1. For the unit ramp input, the value of R of s is equal to 1 by s square. So we have to substitute the value of R of s is equal to 1 by s square in the above equation, means we get C of s is equal to R of s divided by Ts plus 1, that is equal to 1 divided by s square into Ts plus 1. And C of s can be represented as C of s is equal to a divided by s square plus b divided by 1 plus ts plus c divided by s. By partial fraction technique, the value of a, b and c can be calculated. To find the values of a, b and c, we have 1 is equal to a into 1 plus ts plus b square plus cs into 1 plus ts. If we expand this equation, means we get 1 is equal to a plus ats plus b square plus cs plus ct square. That is, s square into b plus ct plus at plus c into s plus a. So if we equate the coefficients of S square term, S term and constant term means we get the values of A, B, C. Now equating constants means we get A is equal to 1. And now equating the S term means we get AT plus C is equal to 0. Put the value of A is equal to 1 in the above equation, we get T plus C is equal to 0. That is, the value of C is equal to minus T. Now equating S square terms means we get 0 is equal to B plus CT. Substitute the values of C is equal to minus T in the above equation means we get 0 is equal to B plus minus T into T. That is, the value of B is equal to T square. Therefore, the value of C of S can be represented as, put the values of A, B and C in the C of S equation means the C of S equation can be represented as 1 divided by S square plus T square by 1 plus TS plus minus T by S. Rearranging the above equations means we get C of S is equal to 1 by S square minus T divided by S plus T square divided by 1 plus TS. C of S is equal to 1 by S square minus T by S plus T divided by 1 S plus 1 by T. Taking inverse Laplace transform of C of S means we get Laplace inverse of C of S is equal to Laplace inverse of open bracket 1 by S square minus T by S plus T divided by S plus 1 by T, close the bracket. If we take the Laplace inverse means Laplace inverse of C of S is C of T. So C of T is equal to Laplace inverse of 1 by S square is T, and Laplace inverse of T by S is capital T. Laplace inverse of T divided by S plus 1 by T is T into e power minus C by T. That is, C of T is equal to T small t minus capital T plus capital T into e power minus T by capital T. That is, C of T is equal to T minus, taking T as common, we get T minus T into open bracket 1 minus e power minus T divided by capital T, close the bracket. The steady state error is given by E suffix SS is equal to limit T tends to infinity open bracket R of T minus C of T, close the bracket. And if you substitute the values of R of T and C of T in this equation means we get E suffix SS is equal to limit T tends to infinity, the value of the R of T for ramp input is T, and the value of the C of T is T minus capital T into open bracket 1 minus e power minus T by T. So these values has been substituted in this equation. That is, E suffix SS is equal to limit T tends to infinity open bracket T minus open bracket T minus T into open bracket 1 minus e power minus T by T, close the brackets. That is, E suffix SS is equal to T after applying the limits T tends to infinity. Since E suffix SS is equal to capital T, the first order system is capable of responding with a finite error capital T. Reducing T not only increases speed of the response of system but also decreases E suffix SS. Time response analysis of first order system subjected to unit impulse input. The closed loop transfer function is given by C of S by R of S is equal to 1 divided by TS plus 1. That is, C of S is equal to R of S into 1 divided by TS plus 1. For impulse input, the value of R of S is equal to 1. So C of S is equal to 1 divided by TS plus 1. That is, C of S can be represented as 1 by T divided by S plus 1 by T. Taking inverse Laplace transform of C of S means we get Laplace inverse of C of S is equal to Laplace inverse of the numerator 1 by T divided by the denominator S plus 1 by T. So C of S Laplace inverse is C of T. C of T is equal to 1 divided by T into e power minus T by T. The steady state error is given by E suffix SS is equal to limit T tends to infinity R of T minus C of T. Under steady state, both the input and output is 0. So E suffix SS is equal to 0. Since transient response analysis is time consuming and does not give any extra information regarding the performance of the system when it is subjected to different test input signals, it is sufficient to conduct the transient response analysis for any one type of standard input signal. By knowing the response to any one test input signal, it is possible to find response to any other standard input signals either by differentiating the response or integrating the response depending on relationship among the standard signals. Thank you very much for listening this lecture. For further updates, kindly subscribe this channel. If you like this video, means kindly share this video to your friends. Thank you.